More snow in the mountains and a bitter wind battering down trees and whistling through our streets. And that's just the start of it, as Sydney and much of the state brace for another powerful cold front.
A brick bungalow in Doonside eclipsed by the neighbour's tree. A mid-morning cold call delivered by a strong and gusty wind.
Oh, I just heard a rumble lasted about 30 seconds. It crashed. Just bricks falling and tiles smashing.
Matt Smith's bathroom bearing the brunt.
Bricks in the toilet, luckily I wasn't in the bath or something.
The forceful breeze barging in before dawn, claiming a car in Cranbrook.
Since midnight we've had just over 330 jobs. And we've seen some pretty high gusts, so 106 kilometres an hour out at Balambi.
Roots up in Warner Vale too. Old oak creeping in on this family home. Power lines the problem in Carlingford, the hazard closing roads, and in Minto, the Sydney storm soundtrack once again echoing through our streets. And at the airport, travellers grounded, 40 cancelled flights.
This wind has left a mark, but we're being told it's not over yet. Brace yourself, because this week, temperatures will plummet to lows of 6 degrees.
Fertile temperatures for our ski fields. Perisher expecting fresh dumps. Threadbow claiming the strongest opening in 20 years. Cold comfort for city dwellers.
It's been really cold, the wind chill. Maybe we need to get her some gloves.
Another round to weather as winter sets in. Ruth Wynne-Williams, Nine News.
Amber's with me in the studio. How strong were those winds today?
Good evening to you, Pete. They were gale force across parts of Sydney northwesterlies, reaching more than 90 kilometres an hour at Fort Denison and at Kurnell, more than 80 in the harbour and Penrith. Further south, Wollongong had its strongest winds in 11 years, hitting 113 kilometres an hour. Officially, it reached a top of 17 degrees in the city this afternoon and nearly 18 in our west, which is right on average for June. However, that wind chill shaved off more than 10 degrees in some suburbs. Just before midday, the airport only felt like an icy 3 degrees. The city felt like 5-7 in Bankstown. It is not going to get much warmer tomorrow, but I'll be back with the full forecast a little later, Pete.
Thank you, Amber.